motivated.
Get motivated.
Get motivated. Hip hop motivated. Flow of wisdom on the mic with Sean Anthony.
Get motivated.
I hope you are motivated. Welcome back to a live edition, Flow of Wisdom Radio, hour two of Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am your host, Sean Anthony. We are live on the Genesis Communications Network every Sunday, 3 to 5 Eastern Standard Time, 12 noon Pacific time. Listen, 877-300-7645, the blood, the significance of the blood. I know I was posing that question rhetorically at the beginning of the show. And I'm taking a trail into the performance artist, Marina Abramovic, okay? And interesting synopsis of this performance artist who is now 70. She just turned 70 years old. And the reason why the significance of her name I'm bringing up, because her name was mentioned, she was in the Podesta WikiLeaks emails. She had correspondence with John Podesta asking if his brother Tony Podesta were going to be appearing at her spirit cooking event at her home that she was going to have. Spirit cooking. Aristocrats of the Soul did an interesting synopsis of Marina Abramovic. It's called The Occult World of Marina Abramovic. And, of course, it says the big news from WikiLeaks release that shows John Podesta, chairman of Hillary Clinton's presidential campaign, was invited to a spirit cooking dinner at the home of the performance artist Marina Abramovic. Internet rumors abounded about Satanism, most of them unfounded. But what is Abramovic's connection to the occult? The article asks. Quick brief synopsis on her history. She was raised in the house of her Orthodox grandmother in communist Belgrade, Serbia. Her great uncle, an Orthodox Christian church leader, became a saint after his death. Abramovic says she has a living altar and is very interested in Tibetan Buddhism. She lived with Aborigines in the Australian outback for a year. She has studied Brazilian crystals, she says. Spirituality is an important part of life and art, distinguishing it from religions, which are institutions. Abramovic calls both Alexandra David Neal and Madame Blavatsky her favorites. For those aren't familiar with Madame Blavatsky, she is behind the whole New Age movement, theosophy. I did a show on her a couple of years, probably 3 years ago. I was talking about the New Age movement. But anyway, Helena Blavatsky was an occultist, and she also wrote the book. She wrote lots of books, but one of them in particular that this article is referencing is Isis Unveiled. The Secret Doctrine is another one. There's some video links on this article as well. Of Lady Gaga, who I mentioned in the previous hour. Lady Gaga practicing what's called the Abramovic method. The Abramovic method. It appears to be a typical mishmash of occult and Eastern traditions. The article points out, of course, she's 69 in this article, but now she's 70, looks much younger, leading people to speculate that occult practices must have kept her youthful, with some calling her a vampire. Given that she's quite wealthy, her anti-aging could be the result of any number of surgeries or treatments reserved for the rich or it could be a result of her life of deep self-exploration, she claims. Women in her family simply live long and don't age. Now, let me just take a quick rabbit trail before I continue on with this article. Because the importance, the significance of what I just read ties into what I shared with you in the first hour. When you look at billionaire Peter Thiel and others that want to extend life, and Peter Thiel wanting to live young by using plasma, the blood of the young, injecting it into himself to preserve youthfulness, okay? Preserving youthfulness by the use of blood. And the article points out to that same ideology, if you will, because of how young this woman looks. She just celebrated her 70th birthday. Now, some may argue, okay, come on, Sean. Some people have good genes, and you know, like she points out in the article, women in her family simply live long and don't age. But the women in your family, do they practice some of the things that you practice? No. Not to mention all of the attention surrounding the spirit cooking and the Podesta scandal. Centered on, there's a photo in this article where she's posing with a bloody goat's head that looks like the Baphomet. What is up with the blood? I seen a very disturbing video with this woman doing her performance art, and according to the information on the video and reading up other articles of this particular performance, was in the 90s. She was using the blood of a pig and semen and all kind of just disgusting stuff. And she's using it to write, I don't know if you want to call it poetry or what have you, on the wall. These big, huge, bare white walls in this blood mixed with all kind of other bodily fluids of who knows what else is all in it. And then some weird, strange little short statue in the corner. She doused it with this engorged blood, bodily fluid concoction and painting over it with a brush. This is the woman that was emailing the person that you were voting for, Hillary Clinton's head honcho, Podesta, inviting them to her spirit cooking event at her home. What do you think goes on at these private dinners for someone that would be invited to something like this on the outside and maybe have no clue to what's really going on? Do you think that they are participating in a occult ritual and not even be privy to it? And I'm talking about like the novice person that's getting invited from a friend of a friend. But then you got these individuals that are in these circles that do participate in these occult sick rituals. I was sent some images last week of artwork that Podesta has in his home. They're very, very, very disturbing because they are of children, paintings of children. Clearly something is a little twisted with some of the images that these people invest in, called art, under the guise of art. This stuff is very, very disturbing as you look into it. Much of Abramovic's performance art is ritualistic, meditative, or even sinister. Such as, and here's a list of some of the things that she's done. Carving a pentagram into her stomach and whipping herself on stage. playing the knife game called Five Finger Filet in one of her performance arts called Rhythm 10. Another, cutting her hair and fingernails and offering them to a burning star, then laying down at the center of it and passing out from the fumes, seen in Rhythm 5. Taking medications of catatonia and schizophrenia. Losing consciousness by inhaling from an industrial fan while naked. Letting her former partner and collaborator of 13 years, Yulei, hold an arrow pointed directly at her heart for 4 minutes. Microphones amplified their racing heartbeats and the creak of the bowstring. Scrubbing 1,500 cow bones for 6 hours a day while singing folk songs from her home country. Then letting an audience do whatever they want to her from a table of 72 props that included grapes, perfume, razor blades, a gun, and one bullet. The performance was stopped when an audience member held the loaded gun to her chest. This stuff is sick, man. 877-300-7645. What are your thoughts on all of this performance art? This is crazy. We'll be back with more right after this on Floor Wisdom Radio. Yeah, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Floor of Wisdom Radio. Sean Anthony here. Floorofwisdom.com. 877-300-7645. Let's take some phone calls. We got Mark in San Francisco talking about the blood and dark occult. Mark in San Francisco, welcome to Floor of Wisdom.
Hey, Sean. I hope today finds you well.
Hey, I'm doing well, Mark. How are you?
Well, I'm hanging too, you know, given all the insanity we find ourselves in the midst of.
Absolutely.
Let me give you a little analogy. This is my take on the blood. Let's look at electronic devices. What powers them? Electricity. So I see the blood in the human body much akin to electricity, say, in your cell phone or your computer or whatever. It's the juice that makes things flow. Now, we're dealing with a bunch of really dark occultists. I have to bring this to all the listeners' attention. The term occult only means hidden. It's knowledge that has been hidden from the masses. But the knowledge itself is neutral. It depends on how you utilize it, for everybody else's benefit or for your own. Now, I see all these transhumanist people, they're driven by two characteristics. The primary one is attachment to the transitory. And the second one is fear of losing their control over their attachment. You still there, Sean?
Absolutely. Yeah, I'm giving you the floor.
Okay, you know, well, and that's the way I see it.
And it's interesting because you're right. With to whom is given, much is required. You know, with electricity, either it can use to light up a city or it can be used to electrocute people in the electric chair.
That's right. Everything is neutral. It depends on how you use it. And mm-hmm. It comes back to our conversation of 2 weeks ago about duality.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah, I totally agree. You know, it's and I've posed this question before on previous shows when I've done series on advanced technology, whether it be the artificial intelligence and some of the I remember doing a story on artificial limbs, you know, for veterans and things of that nature. When in good hands, it's great. It's great for people that are, you know, have, you know, lost the use of their legs. Then I referenced a story from a show talking about the same type of technology where someone hacked these body parts from this company and did nefarious acts with, you know, within them hacking. So the technology and advancement of it, it's all great. I'm all for that. But when you get it in the hands of elite people that want to do nefarious things and alienate others, that's where the problem is. And that's, you know, where we have the, like you said, the duality. You got good versus evil.
That's where it all goes south. You got it, brother.
Yeah. Great analogy.
So I've kind of wrestled with this concept. I don't know whether these people like Peter Thiel or, you know, Bill Gates or George Soros or the rest of these zombies and the ones that we can't find their names out that are really pulling the strings.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not certain whether they're actually possessed by another demonic consciousness or whether they were fashioned that way to begin with, because we do live in a duality. Because there's got to be, if you got good, you got to have evil, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And it's always a battle of good against evil.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Great point, Mark. Thank you so much for the call, man. Great analogy.
All right. Thank you, brother. Have a great day, and I'll see you soon.
You too. Mark in San Francisco. Yeah, and that's amazing because it just drives home the point. You know, with the information, it's only good to those who apply it for the good. You know, that's why I don't buy into the whole notion of overpopulation. You know, and it just it, maybe I'm deviating here, but when I look at the food shortage in certain countries, especially like with certain regions in Africa. And like I said, Venezuela earlier, you got these people that are in control of certain resources and withholding it from others, you know, but then you'll have another country that holds these resources and makes sure that it gets distributed evenly throughout the population. Look, we're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, I'm going to talk to you. I'm going to take some more calls, but I have not forgotten. I'm going to talk to you guys about the tie-in between Jay-Z and Marina Abramovic. Don't go anywhere. Your phone calls, plus that story, and more after this. It's Floor of Wisdom Radio. Oh my goodness. Yo, Leroy is crazy, man. Leroy writes to floorofwisdom.com. Leroy in Atlanta says, sure, she, Marina Abramovic, would kick it with Margaret Singer as well. Could this explain how Lady Gaga got rid of her Bell's palsy? I don't know. And he also writes, Podesta has a little Freddy Krueger in him. Remember what Freddie looks like without his green and red sweater. Yeah, Podesta does got that little Freddy Krueger look, you know, without the claws. Weird man. And he also looks like that guy in, what's that creature in Lord of the Rings? Anyway, 877-300-7645. Let's go to Ohio. Gina in Ohio talking about the blood and rituals. Gina, welcome to Floor of Wisdom.
Hey, Sean, how are you?
I'm doing well. How are you doing?
Good. I'm the one that sent you the email about the In Search of Black Assassins,
yes.
Article.
Yes, I that, posted that.
Know,
by the
I
way,
saw.
Yes, I'm going to let my listeners know, go to floorofwisdom.com. You'll see that article. It's very extensive. It's very informative. It's over 6,000 words, so click on it and after the show and read. But go ahead, Gina. Thank you for that as well.
Oh, and real quick, that same website has a breakdown of prints that ain't nobody ever heard of. It's unbelievable.
Mm-hmm.
Unbelievable. So what I was calling to say is, I don't know why people don't think this is true. The mainstream media is trying to put out there about the fake news, and had a discussion with my husband. He don't believe it. I was like, you really think they gonna get on there and tell these people, you know, your politicians, your heads of country, and all that are into this pedophilia and whatnot? They're not gonna put that out there like that. I mean, but if you ever look at the aerial view of Washington, D.C., you know how satanic it is.
Yeah.
You know how satanic it is. So they can keep playing all these games if they want to, but I know the Most High sees all of it, and they will be judged.
They will. They will. Gina,
simple
thanks.
As that.
Yeah, thanks for that information. Keep it flowing, please.
Not a problem.
All right, peace. Gina in Ohio. Let's go to Florida. Judy in Florida wants to talk about the blood. Judy, welcome to Floor of Wisdom. How are you today?
I'm good, and thank you so very much, Sean. It was just so good to hear you recite the scriptures and God's word at the beginning of the program. That was so, so wonderful. And it is very vital that we, and I am mostly speaking to Christians because those who are lost, they are just lost. But in other words, the most important thing here concerning the blood, which is Christ Jesus' blood, in that is the reason Christ Jesus had to die on the cross, because the scalar waves and the frequency from his blood changes our DNA, and it destroys sin in the human body. And we know that the United Snakes of America, they have ordered a new world, and this is it. And harvesting blood from young babies and children and younger folks, the scale waves that they have is much stronger because they are still in a phase or a state of development. So it is much stronger than an old person. But we have allowed these cults and these secret societies and all of these arts of destruction to come to America. And as I say, the masses, they are truly, truly hypnotized. So I say, stay with the blood of Jesus. That's why he said, flesh and blood shall not enter his kingdom, and you are not going there. So the spirit of Almighty God will be our blood for those of us who are connected with him. I pray that you can remember that. He has changed our blood. This is why sin and death cannot destroy us, and we will not fall for anything. Good speaking with you, Sean. Pleasant evening to you.
You too, Judy. Be blessed. Thank you so much for your call.
All right.
Judy in Florida. All right, let's go to North Carolina. Brother Lyle, North Carolina. Wants to talk about vampire women. Brother Lyle, welcome to Floor of Wisdom, man. How are you?
Yeah, it's the reason they call these people the snake people. I mean, these people are on a very high spiritual level of wickedness. I think she's on a level with Chris Angel, Mind Freak, and that guy David Blaine. You know, you seen the video where he spit up the three frogs out of his mouth.
Right.
I mean, mimicking what Revelation says. I mean, this is not hocus pocus. That's real. That's
real, man.
That, you know, I mean, they have sold themselves to the point where, you know, they have all this power, but I mean, I ain't gonna say there's no coming back, but I think they pretty much crossed that line where, you know, they understand that, you know, Christ is coming back and they're gonna be war against him, and they feel that they're going to be soldiers in their army, so they're trying to extend their life so they can be ready for the battle and, you know, of Armageddon. And the thing about it is they're introducing the public to this, and it's a lot of people that look at that and say, man, you know, I want to get on this. And, you know, in a few years, they're going to be able to give this stuff to people, you know, pretty inexpensively, you know, with the chip and everything. And they said you can have the same kind of life extension as billionaires and millionaires, but they're not going to tell the people that, hey, it's going to be at the cost of them not getting into heaven.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, man, you're hitting the nail on the head when you talk about these high level of wickedness.
No, it's not hocus pocus. It's not no cheap card game that they're doing. This is real stuff.
This is real magic. This is real black magic or whatever title you want to put on it. Like Lyle is saying, this is the real deal. And, you know, you can play around with it if you want to, but that stuff is powerful as well.
I don't know if you've seen the video of the guy levitating over that building in London. That new skyscraper that they had, you know, erected, and it was like 72 stories high. Wow. And he went in when they was like dedicating it, and he went up to the top of the building, and he levitated. Mm. I mean, like, I forgot how many feet in the air, and people was like, is that real? I mean, it was real. There was no wires or nothing on this guy. I mean, he was levitating off of the building. Over, with his hands out, like he was crucified.
I know I've seen several videos of David Blaine, the magician, levitating.
It's real.
Yeah, levitating right there, just standing right there around a crowd of people.
It's not a crowd of people standing.
Yeah. It's crazy, man. Thanks for the call. I appreciate it, man.
All right, thanks, Sean.
Bye. Yes, sir. Leroy in Atlanta, Pizzagate. Talk about it, man. Welcome to Flow of Wisdom. How you doing?
Hey, man, that essay, let's start off with the word. You know, in Genesis 4, verse 10, the Lord said to Cain, and he said, what hast thou done? The voice of thy brother's blood crieth unto me from the ground. After, you know, Cain had murdered him. And in Cain, the last name of who would be vice president, the Hillary Clinton, should they succeed in stealing the election, steal from Donald Trump. But then to go to Pizzagate, yeah, I've heard the reports too, as the other caller stated, that main or lamestream news is trying to portray that as the fake story because some man from North Carolina did his own investigation and walked up into the pizza joint, shot it up with an AR and a 38, and he survived. He turned himself in. I mean, why didn't they use C4 and a robot to blow him up like they did the guy down in Dallas?
Well, he didn't kill five cops.
Oh, okay. So the prerequisite to getting shot by cops is you got to kill cops, not being naked or unarmed.
Right.
Man, it's a sinful, sick world we living in right now. But stay faithful.
Go ahead, man, because I was just going to, you know, it's crazy, and I'll let you wrap up, that what you just said, it's only going to get worse. It's going to be revealed. More and more of this sick, vile wickedness is going to be revealed, and it's imperative for us to stay rooted. You understand what I'm saying?
Oh, absolutely. And you know what? For them to come out and try and portray that as the fake story tips their hand to let us know that it's real. Because if somebody's lying on you, you don't really have to defend yourself. You see what I'm saying? If somebody's lying on you, because the truth stands on its own. And we know who he is. You know what I mean?
Absolutely, man. And thank you for that. And, you know, it's interesting. I posted this on the Facebook, the Flow of Wisdom Facebook page. Over 1 million people in South Korea are protesting. 1.5 million people. You got to see the aerial view of that. Because of the corruption with the leader. The article is all up there. I don't want to go too far into it. But go to facebook.com/flowofwisdom and look at the shots. My point in bringing that up is tying into what you said, Leroy. The more the people start realizing the truth, when is the United States going to have that kind of revolution? You know what I'm saying? Where we demand that this wickedness be changed. 1.5 million people in South Korea protesting. It's amazing, man. But thanks for the call, Lee.
Absolutely. Hey, let me say this. Hey, it's going to get worse before it gets better. But when it gets better, it's going to be the best because our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ will be here.
Word. All right, man.
Amen. Y'all Amen. Keep praying.
All right, man. Leroy in Atlanta talking about Pizzagate. When will that type of revelation happen? Can it happen here in the United States? Are we too, what they think, too dumb, deaf, and blind to see the truth? Well, I tell you, with this social media, we're able to see behind the facade what the media is trying to portray now, saying what's fake news and not. Come on now. How about we read your historical books and look at that and look at the patterns and see how fake that news is. We'll be right back with Jay-Z linked to Marina. Couple of months ago, when the Podesta email leaks came out regarding Marina Abramovic and the spirit cooking, and I seen her image. When I first seen her image, I kept saying, like, this woman looks familiar, and I just can't put my finger on it yet. So after I did a little bit more digging, I was like, aha, I remember where I seen her before. And several years ago, Jay-Z released a video online. It was off his new album at the time, the Magna Carta album, okay? And it was a music video that he did called Picasso Baby. When you guys go online, go on YouTube, watch this video, you will see Marina Abramovic in this video with Jay-Z. Here's an excerpt from an article on that in the New Yorker. When Abramovic appeared serene in a voluminous black gown, the room fell silent. Quote, I need energy from everybody. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, a member of the production crew barked to the stunned crowd. The artist slunk in, discarding her shoes and her belt along the way, holding her arms out to the side, palms facing forward. What followed was a slow, seductive dance, the artist and the rapper pacing around, staring intently into each other's eyes, occasionally pressing their foreheads together. The mind melt complete. Quote, I had no idea what I was going to do, Abramovic said afterward. I just came here, felt the energy. I love his music because it's social issues, it's political, and really goes to everybody's heart. It's so good. It's like a volcano. That was her remarks after videoing the video. Now, Jay-Z took the concept of this video shoot from Marina Abramovic's whole performance art. Jay-Z stood for six hours, continuously performing Picasso Baby while people would enter in and enter out as he continued to perform this song in front of people. So when you see the video off, this album, Magna Carta, Holy Grail, Picasso Baby, you'll see this is a rendition of Marina Abramovic's performance art. Okay. Now, after that, articles came out that Marina Abramovic was, quote, pissed at Jay-Z, says he completely used her, saying that he was supposed to donate to her nonprofit charity. Her art charity. And she went out in the public and the media and said that she was pissed at Jay-Z, said he completely used her. Well, she had to eat her words because apparently it was the Marina Abramovic Institute, MAI. Marina Abramovic was not informed that Sean Jay-Z Carter's donation from 2 years ago, when she recently did an interview in Spike magazine in Brazil, saying that we are sincerely sorry to both Marina Abramovic and Sean Jay-Z Carter for this. And since then, they have talked to appropriate and took appropriate actions to reconcile this matter. My point bringing this up, ladies and gentlemen, is you know, on one side, I can see, you know, Jay-Z trying to expand my art. You know, Jay-Z now has been very vocal over the recent years talking about how much he's into art now and buying art and collecting art, expensive art and so on, et cetera. But man, I wonder if he knew, and I'm sure he, this guy is not a he doesn't come off as a dumb guy. I just scratch my head as to looking into her history before pairing up and doing this performance with Picasso Baby. But nonetheless, one of my mentors always says, show me your bank account and your calendar, and I'll see what your priorities are. Hence, Jay-Z, his bank account clearly shows that he donates to Marina Abramovic Institute and this project that he agreed to donate to Marina's charities, the same project that Lady Gaga has helped work on her with. Look, we ran out of time. Great show. I love the callers. Lord willing, we'll be back next Sunday giving you more information. 3 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. Follow me on floralwisdom.com. Live life, get wisdom, and let it flow. I'm Sean Anthony. Peace.